fuck! Oh my god, don't just sneak up on people like that, shit. Get like an announcer, make yourself known, fuck!
Ah, summertime. Summer break, hanging out with your friends. Sunburn, increasingly hot temperatures, a scorching reminder that our planet is heating up and there's nothing we can do to stop it because the people causing the problem are never going to change their ways because it's profitable. Super Mario Sunshine, released back on the GameCube in 2002, and has always been one of those weird Mario games for me. I looked up examples for weird Mario games on Google, and what would you look at that? It's right there. Like, think about the other 3D Marios before and after this. Mario 64 has Mario trying to save Peach from Bowser, pretty generic plot setup. Mario Galaxy is the same thing, but in space. And then there's Mario Sunshine, where Mario, Princess Peach, and a bunch of other Toads are off to an island vacation. That island known as Isle Delfino. Okay, so just getting some stuff out of the way. I am playing this on official hardware for the most authentic experience possible, and I'm genuinely not sure if I got OBS to record this in the correct aspect ratio. Like, even watching this footage back, I'm not sure if I got it right. Let's start off with this box art, and... wow. Can't read any of this. Did the f***ing Zodiac Killer make this box art? What is this text trying to say? I also should probably give some background on the game, shouldn't I? Alright, I'll make this quick. So, Nintendo wanted to make a new Mario game, and they did. As they're touching down, their landing is interrupted by this icky paint-like goop, and wage slave Mario has to clean it up. Even though these people who I assume are working here at this airport could do it, they just don't. No problem at all though, because we quickly find the main gimmick of the game. This is the Flash Liquidizer Ultra Dowsing Device, or Flood. Hey, sorry I look completely different now. My waterproof microphone sure as hell wasn't that. So now I have no hat, I wasted $60, and you get visible boom mic. Now Flood can do some pretty neat stuff. Pressing in on the R button will let you spray water, and fully pressing it will let you lock in place so you can spray more accurately. Or alternatively, you can hit Y and it'll zoom really close in so you can see what you're spraying, while hitting X will change which nozzle you're using. The default one you get though is the hover nozzle, which will let you hover in place for a little while. I'll go into more detail about Flood and Mario's movement as a whole in a little bit, but for right now we have to clean up this slop. Also, it's alive somehow, so we water it to death, and we can grab our first shine. These are our main collectible of the game, so like the stars from Mario 64. But what's the reason for this difference? Why not just have stars again? Well, that's explained in the next cutscene. The police show up, and they do like all good police officers do, and immediately arrest somebody who looks different from them, and make him stand trial. Apparently, some Mario impasta has been going around messing up Isle Delfino, getting a ton of that same paint just everywhere, as well as stealing the shine sprites. The shine sprites give Isle Delfino sunlight, and without it, the whole island is coated in darkness. And they lock up Mario for the crimes he didn't commit. Okay, just a few things. For starters, a foreign diplomat is here alongside this guy, and she's saying he's innocent. Secondly, shouldn't they know who Mario is? Thirdly, how did this mysterious device get left at an airport and nobody do anything about it? And fourthly, oh, you motherfuckers saw that guy get off the plane. This is not the same person.
Goddamn, the lack of realism in my Mario games.
They compromise letting him out of prison if he cleans up the entire island. So wait, you're just going to let this presumed criminal out of jail and leave him to his own devices? Okay, sure. I think these police officers said something about keeping an eye on us, but I really could not hear them over the audio mixing.
Your first job's to get rid of all that ugliness. And remember, we'll be watching you, pal. We'll know if you start slacking off.
He's doing what off?
It's our job to get every last one of those shine sprites back and clean things up. So we need to go defeat another one of those big goopy guys, except they're slightly more difficult now. Same story as last time, but after clearing this one, a giant statue rises from the ground and that Mario imposter shows himself. This is Shadow Mario, the man behind the mischief. Running over, grabbing Peach, and sprinting away. Fear not, Princess Mario, the Flower Master is here to save you! The nasty thing finally drops Peach and escapes into our first level of the game, Bianco Hills. Basically, this game's Ba-Bomb Battlefield, or literally any other first level of a video game. I don't know why that comparison was necessary. But by all means, prepare me to make it again in about 30 seconds. Here, we're introduced to a bunch of different level gimmicks and ideas that'll be prevalent throughout the rest of the game. For starters, the first one is defeating another one of those goop creatures in order to get a shine. Or the second level where we get our first boss of the game, PD Piranha. It's so weird to me that this is the first appearance this guy made in the Mario series. He just kind of showed up one day in my mind. PD is guarding a shine, so we need to Jesus Christ blur that in order to get it from him. And unfortunately, I kind of don't like this boss. Allow me to compare it to King Ba-Bomb from Mario 64 since it's been 30 seconds. The first boss of Mario 64 was King Ba-Bomb. How the fight plays out is you have to run behind him and throw him around. Do that 3 times and he's gone. It's a good boss since it challenges the player on using Mario's movement and creative ways to outsmart him, and especially since grabbing somebody and throwing them is required later for fighting Bowser. There is even a significant risk if you mess up because he can grab you, then throw you off the cliff, meaning you'll have to get back to the top of the mountain. He is an amazing first boss. So how does Mario Sunshine do its first boss? It's just a painfully boring boss fight. You have to spray him with water when he opens his mouth and ground pound his belly button. That's literally it. Do it 3 times. If you don't, he'll spray goop everywhere, I guess, but it's stupidly easy to avoid. This first boss just sucks. The third shine for the stage introduces us to special stages. These are areas where Shadow Mario steals Flood and you have to navigate them without the aerial safeguard it once provided. I think this is a great time to talk about how Mario controls and what he can do in this game.
He's got all the classics: running, jumping, triple jumps, wall jumps, dives, the works. But new to this game is the spin jump. Fiddle with your stick and you can go spinning into the air. So if there's a wall nearby and you need to get up to somewhere, give it that classic spin jump, wall jump into Flood hover. But wait just a second, now that Flood is gone, how does Mario control?
That was all from one level, by the way.
Alright, joking aside, it's actually really immersive. This truly feels like my controller's wet! He just feels so damn slippery. Trying to operate him without the safety net that Flood provides for overshooting or undershooting jumps just feels impossible. Like trying to ride a bicycle without safety wheels. Or the handlebar. Okay, it's unfair to judge how Mario plays when it's specifically without one of the things that makes playing as him fun. I actually don't hate controlling him like you might think. When you have Flood on you, it's really fun with all the crazy tricks you can do. But there are some things I don't like about it though. Like his dive. I became so reliant on using Flood that it was really discouraging to use the dive move. See, if you want to get out of a dive, you have a few options. Just slide until he stops, which takes way too long. Or jump out of it, continuing your momentum. Which would be cool for platforming if I could use Flood out of this. Instead of doing whatever the hell this is. And another thing, you can't change your momentum in the air without Flood. I mean, you technically can a little, but not anything noticeable or meaningful. If you jump, you are stranded to following whichever arc you took. The only way you can even alter it a little bit is by using the spin jump, which barely helps. I just don't understand why they would make stages that take away your primary movement option when it's this necessary. Now that I'm thinking about it, Mario Odyssey has stages where it takes away your core mechanic as well. Sometimes there will be stages where you need to throw Cappy onto a scarecrow and enter a room without him. What I think differentiates them though is Mario Odyssey Mario without Cappy is still controllable. The special stages for Mario Sunshine are not. Which makes me wonder why the hell they would be here in the first place if the only times where it feels like my controller's covered in WD-40 are these levels. I don't know if I'm being honest with you, this wasn't really going anywhere. Shine 5 at least stars Petey Piranha returning, so I guess it's time for his redemption. It's the same boss from last time, but this time it's longer. He has these new tornado attacks, but they can't damage you, and they literally just make the fight take way longer. This next level introduces two new nozzles you can switch out for, both being undoubtedly more situational, but still being useful. We got the hover nozzle and the rocket nozzle. I'm floating away. Both of these are very niche in their uses, but how we think about it is that these power-ups are keys and the areas you get to them with are locks. You need to go out and find a nozzle you need so you can complete whatever challenge the stage demands. For example, the rocket nozzle, after a short charge, will send you skyrocketing to the air, which is used to get to higher areas of Bianco Hills. And the turbo nozzle lets you charge up and run extremely fast, which lets you cross large bodies of water faster and break through these gates. Hey, wait a minute, this isn't footage from Bianco Hills. This shine sucks! Okay, so you first need to get across this lake, but this time it's covered in poisonous goop, and you would assume that handy-dandy turbo nozzle would help you get across, right? No, it's at the very end! I guess in case you've changed your mind and wanted to turn around, what's at the other end of the lake is. I think it's time we start being more positive. I'm choosing to ignore this shine. Massive shoutouts to this invisible wall killing me, I think I'll make a 4-hour video about that. But anyway, a shine I really like from here is the 7th one. You just have to chase down Shadow Mario until you spray him enough to drop a shine. It's simple, but I like it. And finally, the 8 red coins shine. Don't pretend you're unaware, everybody knows about the 8 red coins. Gather all 8 of these hidden around the level and you'll get your shine. But that's all of the shine sprites in this level, which is technically a lie, but I'll talk about that later. I won't be going this in-depth with all of the stages, I just thought this first one was a great way to show off what's to come for the rest of the game. Shine's devoted to special stages, chasing down Shadow Mario, boss fights, boss refights, 8 red coins, and bullshit. All of these are Mario Sunshine staples. Well, the game kept zooming in on this random pile of goop every time I exited the stage, so I guess I'll go there next. Hidden underneath of this is the portal to Rico Harbor. Rico Harbor introduces us to several new gimmicks, including but not limited to these grates you can smack on to get to the other side of, kind of like the ones in Mario World, these manholes you can go down to get to the other side of the map faster, and this stupid f***ing idiot dumb stupid ass burn in hell squid. Shine 2 and Shine 6 both require you ride these bloopers in order to complete them. Okay, yeah, that's pretty cool, like jet skiing. Yeah, except that, but imagine playing F-Zero, but anytime you bump into anything, you instantly explode. That is what this is. At least in F-Zero, you can slow down. There's this race course Stars and Shine 2 you have to go through in order to get it, it's just abysmal. Look at this one turn. Could you react to that block being there? I sure f***ing couldn't. Okay, so that's fine. Get the Shine, get out. But Shine 6 might be the worst one by far. The same blooper racing with dodging obstacles, but this time you have to hit 8 little ass targets. And reminder, if you touch anything that isn't a coin,
he'll die on the spot!
Okay, so you finally complete the race course after a couple tries, and this happens. Okay, genuinely, was that Shine playtested? Outside of that, though, I really enjoyed Rico Harbor. The boss is pretty fun, unlike the last one. Big Blooper, whatever his name was, I felt terrible killing, but was fun nonetheless. You have to spray its face, then rip off its tentacles, and they start squirming around, and it damn near made me vomit. After that, you need to smack its face and repeat the same thing in phase 2. It's simple, but I like it. There was another Shine where you had to climb to the top of a giant construction zone, which I thought was really cool. I just put in my notes another dumbass special stage, so that's all I'm saying. Obviously chasing Shadow Mario again, and the final one, which didn't work for some reason. Strange, I say it's best we move on and never think about this non sequitur ever again. Really fun level, and its music really got stuck in my head. Honestly, my favorite part of Mario Sunshine might just be the music. There's barely any songs in the game I would even consider bad. Even the special stage themes at least make those stages more bearable. I'll play the noteworthy songs as we go along, but just know the entire soundtrack is great. Another thing I really like about the stage is the aesthetics. Just all of the boats going around looks really charming. And combine that with a little town up at the top and you have yourself a pretty fine ass level, I do say so myself. I guess I technically didn't give my thoughts on the last one, if I liked it or not. I did not. But yeah, ignoring Hitler and Hitler Returns, Rico Harbor is a good level in my book. And sorry ahead of time if I'm more brief on some stages than others. It's just I want to save specific topics for when they're more relevant. After some kind of well thought out segue, we have Gelato Beach next. Now surprisingly, this is our first beach themed level of the game, which is kind of shocking considering Mario Sunshine's whole aesthetic. This cute little village with all these little dudes living in it just looks so pleasant to me. And hell, I'm glad it at least looks nice because it is not. Holy shit, I think this is the worst level yet. It starts off with this obnoxious ass special stage with degenerating sand platforms. It's just amazing when you don't have flood. You have to get these giant cataquacks off these panels, which is actually not that bad. You have to spray them off the edge and then catapult them off. It would have been way more enjoyable if I didn't have to sit through a 10 second cutscene every time I defeated one though. This next shine is a great time to introduce the main gimmick of the level. Outside of these duck enemies that launch you thousands of feet in the air, there are these little dudes you can spray and also launch you thousands of feet in the air. Boy, how wonderful! That latter thing is how you defeat the boss of this level, this big old wiggler. It literally just boils down to waiting for it to run over to you and then launching it. It's the same thing with Petey Piranha again, you just wait! I hope the next shine picks up, oh god. So, this is the iconic sand bird that's associated with Mario Sunshine, and I'm going to be real, it is way over-dramatized. I got this thing on my second try, come on people. It's actually a really cool idea for an 8 red coin star. You just collect all of them on its wings and try not to fall off. It's a really neat twist on the old concept of gathering coins. Throw all of that out the window though, because Shine 6 is another 8 red coin star and it is obnoxiously bad. You need to go around this coral reef collecting 8 red coins that are hidden in the coral, which is a cool concept except that there are two that will move away from you. So you just need to swim after them in your hunky dory, right? Wrong, they can go through walls actually. And the worst part is when they're not near you, they move incredibly slowly. So if one of them just happens to face of the earth, tough shit, you have to wait there for it to resurface. Why didn't they just put it on a set path? What the hell were these developers thinking? All right, let's break this up here with two shines I did enjoy. There's this one guy named Piantissimo who will race you to a different part of the level, kind of like Koopa the Quick from Mario 64, and obviously chasing down Shadow Mario, but they haven't really innovated on that concept yet, so I don't really have too much to say. Shine 8 might be the worst one yet, I am not kidding. You need to roll this watermelon from one side of the area to the other, right? Well, if anything, Dare looks at this thing the wrong way, it immediately explodes. And there's like a billion of those cataquack enemies just everywhere. If it touches a tree, it explodes. If it touches an enemy, it explodes. If it touches a breeze, it explodes. Then you finally get this stupid fruit to the guy who wanted it, and he goes, "No, it's too small, give me a different one." Kill yourself! Damn it all, I'm going back to the better level. I will give the level this though, it's probably one of the best looking ones in the whole game. This water and the coral reef area for the damn GameCube holds up really well. In terms of graphics, the game has aged greatly. In terms of everything else...
Well, that was Gelato Beach. God, this game better pick up soon.
So it looks like this vaguely Bowser-themed ship has parked itself at the dock, so I guess we'll go look at that now. Since law enforcement literally never does anything, Princess Peach has been captured by Shadow Mario again, and they get away to our next location, Pinup Park. Immediately upon our arrival, Shadow Mario is waiting for us and runs over to a giant Bowser mech. Alright, so you're probably expecting me to hate this shine because everybody else does, but I actually really enjoy this one. You're riding in this roller coaster car, having to micromanage firing rockets and spraying bullet bills. It works surprisingly well. Probably one of my favorite shines so far. We destroyed the big old machine, and it turns out Shadow Mario isn't all that he seems. He's actually new character to the Mario series, Bowser Jr. Same thing with Petey Piranha, I keep forgetting these two debuted in this game. So Bowser told Bowser Jr. that we kidnapped Princess Peach and needed to get his mother back. No f***ing way he pulled that off. Turns out Bowser had bribed the Piantas, which is the name of most of the characters in this game, I just forgot to bring it up, into throwing Mario into the slammer. Oh, okay, it wasn't racist profiling, it was just government corruption. So he grabs Peach and they blast off to Corona Mountain, where they'll rest until the end of the game, maybe. And it's now up to us to grab enough shines to come rescue her. Just going off of memory from the last time I played this game, I'm pretty sure we need like 50, but we're still doing every shine up to it anyways. Speaking of gathering shines, I really like this next one in Pinup Park, where you have to get this Monty Mole in a giant cannon to stop being a dick. You have to spray these bob bombs and throw them back at him. It's a simple but pretty good boss fight, and once he's defeated you can finally go inside the tank and find MOTHERFUCK! There's an 8 red coins shine that's pretty annoying on some pirate ship. There's these turtle dudes on this beach you have to destroy so these flowers can bloom again. This is pretty fun, they kinda remind me of Pikmin enemies. We have to climb to the top of this Ferris wheel, which literally does not work because of the camera, so I just said screw it and climb to the top of the tallest nearest structure and that worked. And the next shine, which is also unbeatable for some reason, like the one back in Rico Harbor. Well, to unlock these, we need to go back to the hub and catch Shadow Mario again. He's running away with a Yoshi egg, and after we take it back and give it the fruit it wants, Yoshi can now be found in any of the levels. I just don't know. So Yoshi plays a bit differently from Mario. He can jump, triple jump, eat fruit with his tongue, spit that fruit back out with his disgusting hose face, and of course his classic flutter. Eating a different fruit will change the color of your Yoshi and by proxy which fruit he spits out. Now why would you want to change his color? Well, for certain puzzles that require it. Like back at Pinup Park, this Yoshi go-round is missing its orange Yoshi. So you need to go and find a Yoshi, feed it a fruit it wants to get out of its shell, then find a fruit to change its color to orange. And after all of that hard work, you get a come on! How the hell does that one even make sense? Dude, I know I've already said this stuff and I've made my peace with it, but these special stages, man, Jesus. Mario Sunshine just does not work without flood, okay? It would be like trying to play Kirby, but randomly in one of the levels, they just say, yeah, let's remove the inhale for no reason. And this one might genuinely be the worst one yet. There are these stupid platforms you have to wait an eternity on. And the lighting in this one in particular makes it impossible to tell where you're jumping. Or how about when you grab the ledge to a block that's moving away from you and Mario decides, fuck it, it's void time. If you removed all of these from the game, you would technically lose a lot of content, but that's like saying removing Ebola from a dish removes a part of the experience. If there is genuinely a special stage that's worse than this, then I'm gonna f***ing lose it, man. Anyway, we catch Shadow Mario for Shine 7.
And to cap off Pinup Park, we have the roller coaster balloon ride, which is about as fun as being shot.
Okay, so it's the Bowser roller coaster thing again, but this time it's not even remotely fun. You have to hit these little ass targets while getting flung around at a billion miles per hour on this roller coaster, and you have a limited amount of ammo, and you only have 3 laps to do it, and there's 20 to hit, and you get executed if you don't get all of them, and God, this game is getting on my nerves. Okay, so how about another thing I liked about Mario Sunshine to mix things up? This game is immersive as hell. At any time you want, you can hit Z to view the map, which isn't very interesting by itself. But no matter which location you're at on Isle Delfino, you can see the other levels to go to. So you can see Rico Harbor from Gelato Beach, or you can see pretty much every level at the top of Pinup Park. And they're consistent with this too. No matter where you are in the world, you'll be able to see the other levels nearby. They never just go, whoops, forgot to put that part into the distance. No, you'll always be able to see everything. Even levels I haven't gotten to yet. Speaking of which, we should move on. Pinup Park was extraordinarily okay, and we get back to the hub to search for the next level. Alright, so I've already grabbed enough shines to do one of two different levels here, and instead of choosing immediately, I say we talk about the hub world itself. And in terms of hub worlds in Mario games, this takes the cake for the best one easily. It's so fun to jump around these buildings like in Assassin's Creed or just screw around instead of doing the next objective. It even features some extra shines to grab, like this one guy who throws you through a window letting you grab one. Or the bonus levels! If you know about Mario Sunshine, you know about the bonus levels. So how are they? Right, so if you've ever heard about this game's insane difficulty, you've no dir- Wow, I really messed that up, didn't I?
There is so much ash in the pool.
Right, so if you've heard about this game's insane bullshit, there's no doubt you've heard about these upcoming levels. Let's start with the classic pachinko machine.
This is legitimately the biggest buggy mess of a shine in the entire game. I'll contradict that in a second, but here's what you have to do.
Also, sorry if this footage looks a little pixely. I messed up how the Retron settings worked. Whoops.
There are 8 red coins you must collect, and you have to launch Mario to collect them. 3 are just handed to you at the start, so you only have to worry about 5. 2 on the left, 2 on the right, and 1 in the center. The problem is none of this fucking works. Okay, so I launched Mario upwards, and I try to hit this first one that's immediately to the right after you exit. Well, the gods of go f*** yourself decided to put the most obtrusive invisible wall, making Mario coast immediately towards the center. How do you go to the left one? Pure chance. Literally, look at this footage of how I ended up getting this. I just broke the whole thing by wall jumping against surfaces you are explicitly not supposed to be able to do that on. It feels like my input does nothing. It's almost entirely random what will happen when you jump in. And if you fall to the very bottom, the game just kills you for it. And if you run out of lives, it means you have to go back to the hub and back into it again, which means waiting for the stupid boat to go underneath where its entrance is. And if you miss the boat, you have to wait 2 solid minutes for it to come back. This is the shittiest shine in the whole game, definitively. Second worst. So the pachinko machine level only took me 30 minutes, which is absurd for one shine, but pales in comparison to the lily pad level. Timing wise, this stage only took me 10 minutes. To get to. Allow me to break down what you need to do in order to get this shine. Plainly and orderly. First, you need to get Yoshi, who's on top of this rooftop here. He requires a random fruit to come out of his egg, and after he's gotten whichever fruit he demands, you can ride him. Then you must take Yoshi and hop on top of this boat going over to this island. You can't just swim there because Yoshi dissolves in water, right? Then you have to wait on this island for a different boat to come over and hop onto it. Then you must wait until you get to this pier in the middle of the ocean, then wait there for another boat to arrive. After it does, you can jump onto it and wait until you reach this little island where Yoshi is required. You have to use his juice spraying ability to clear off the top of this pipe and enter it. From there, you can finally enter the special stage. In order to get the shine, you have to collect 8 red coins on top of the lily pad on raging water. You can't just swim in the water because it's poisonous and you'll die if you touch it. And since it's running water, you can't go backwards, so if you miss one, you must restart. This game was made to hurt me. Who in their right mind designed this and thought it was okay? I'm convinced this game was made to torture me, if I'm being completely honest with you. Genuinely, I was dedicated to doing this game glitchless until I sat here for 8 minutes waiting for boats to come near. All you have to do is run into this wall at a funny angle and boom, underneath the map. It's really that easy. And that's just getting into it. Once you're actually there, it's torture. And when you inevitably game over, you can't just get into it like the pachinko machine. You have to wait on top of the damn boats again. I could excuse all of this if the shine was any easier because Jesus Christ, you can't go backwards on it, so if you miss one, tough shit, do it again. The only saving grace of this is that there's a 1-up along the stream, so maybe if you're lucky, you can grab it. But that's all the stupid River's Mercy. At least it functions on, like, the pachinko machine, but that's really not a saving grace now, is it? Horrible shine. Took me 45 minutes in total.
Alright, I just want to get those two out of the way because... obviously. But the rest of the shines hidden in the hub are actually pretty fun.
Now, bonus missions aren't just the only shines you can get here. There are also ones just in Delfino Plaza itself. Like the aforementioned man who throws you through a window, or this one that requires the rocket nozzle to go into this room. They are there, I guess, nothing notable. Except for this one that's hidden in the sand that you have to spray a completely random part of in the beach to get, that kind of felt cheap. Anyway, this bonus mission where you go down this Mario 64-esque slide, this one where you need to do a turbo dash the whole time, and one where you need to collect 8 red coins in this planter box. These were all pretty fun ignoring Satan and Satan 2. We can also go back to the airstrip for the beginning of the game, but I think we're gonna have to wait a little bit longer till we can do that. I say for right now we head back to the levels, and there's a bunch available to me right now. But I'm just going to go to the one the camera keeps focusing on every time I get a shine, so we're off to Noki Bay. So Noki Bay is a 100% vertical level, and I'm going to be honest with you, this might be one of my favorite levels in the whole game. I mean, of course there were shines I didn't like, but at worst they were just mediocre. This is the first level to actually follow a concrete storyline. The Nokis, who are these old dudes, are having a pollution problem, and their first suspect is the Cannon Monty Mole back from Gelato Beach. And as I just said a second ago, this is our first and only vertical level of the game. And honestly, it works so well for how Mario Sunshine controls. Doing a bunch of cool flips and stuff to get up to the top feels so satisfying. Once you get there, it's the same boss again, not that interesting. But it turns out that wasn't the actual cause of pollution. It was actually the blue coin that caused my game to crash. Everything actually points to this giant eel at the bottom of the ocean, so you're given a new power-up to go fight it. Mario dons a little scuba helmet and can now move move around much more freely in the water, accelerating really quickly and using flood to get upwards. I've seen so many people complain about how he maneuvers underwater with this power, but I have no idea what they're talking about. This feels fine, shut up. After a demo of collecting 8 red coins with this, you can go fight the eel, but instead of spraying it until it dies or something like that, we just need to clean its teeth so it'll stop spreading all of those toxins. Yet again, I've seen people from all over the internet complain about this big old eel, and I was really expecting to hate it, but after I cleaned its teeth and got the shine, it wasn't exactly an engaging boss, so you just kinda had to hover over certain spots of it. But damn it, that's a new record for this game. After that though, it kinda just loses the whole point of us being here. We just kinda go back to collecting nonsense shines. Like killing this big squid for the third time or racing Piantissimo again. And yes, it even has its own special stage. But you know what's magical about Noki Bay? I don't hate this special stage. Like Noki Bay itself, it's vertically oriented. So with the right movement, you can just skip entire chunks of it. What the fuck happened here? Why was this level so good? This is the peak of the entire game, and it's just some random ass optional world you can go to. What? The aesthetics of this one are firing on all cylinders as well. This is the only level in the whole game you can't see from any other location. It's just this little secluded village nestled in the cliffside, and it feels so peaceful to be in. The music is nothing notable, but damn it, that's my only complaint about this place. Noki Bay is probably my favorite part of the entire run. It's so nice that there's finally something good to experience here. It just makes everything up to this point feel worth it. And hey, who says we should stop here? Let's see what the next level is. Serena Beach is the worst level in the entire game, I am convinced. The amount of horse shit that this puts you through is maniacal. So for starters, the first shine. This big old manta ray got electric gunk everywhere and we have to defeat it. This boss annoys me to wit's end. It just keeps splitting up and it never dies and I hate this. Then the second shine is a special stage, and you know those things track record. And shine number three takes the cake for the stupidest shine in the entire game. Are you ready for me to lay out the most devious and maniacal things you need to go through in order to get this? I hope you are, cause I'm gonna. For starters, you're not given any direction on what you're supposed to be doing. Most of the shines give you at least a hint for what you have to do in the name. 8 red coins of the lake, cash Shadow Mario, let's goes on. But this one is just called Mysterious Hotel Delfino, and that's because I'm not sure if the developers even knew what the hell this was supposed to be. As soon as you enter the hotel, you're up to your own devices to figure out what you're supposed to do. There's a shine on the very top floor behind some glass you can't access, so what do you do? Well, you'll notice immediately upon entry there's a Yoshi egg to the left side that wasn't there in the previous mission. Obviously, the objective is to open it, but how? He wants a pineapple, and the fruit vendor across from him has everything but. You can try all of the rooms upstairs, but they're all locked. Allow me to give you the solution. You need to go into the bathroom, go to the very last stall, and jump through the ceiling. Then you need to go over this painting and spray it with water, causing a silhouette of a Buddha manifest and letting you continue forward. Then in the next room, you need to spray this closet door until all of them flip over and you can walk through it. Then you need to spray these pink booze to create platforms so you can go to this lady's floor. Then you need to spray her cabinet so you can go to the room adjacent to hers and slam through the floor. Then in breaking open one of these boxes, you can finally find your pineapple. Okay, great, now I have a Yoshi, now what? Now you're required to go to the third floor and head into this one room that isn't locked, so you can jump through the ceiling. There are giant boos up there that only Yoshi can deal with, so that's why he's required. So finally, you can navigate over to the shine and ground pound through the floor so you can nab it. But watch out, because there are fake spots to ground pound meant to trip you up. Keep in mind, you only have a limited amount of time on Yoshi, and if you don't eat a fruit in a while, you'll lose him. And you'll have to repeat the entire process if this happens. But after trial and error, you can get the shine. I got nothing. This game was made for kids, you know. Children. Stupid little baby dumb idiot children. How can you expect a child to have the ability to figure this out? Dude, I was 15 playing this game and I needed a fucking guide. That was completely nonsense. How could I just be expected to know to go through the roof of the bathroom? Or be expected to know that any of the things I'm doing are the right path because nothing points to a damn pineapple being this direction? How can I be expected to know that one of the rooms is unlocked so I can jump to the attic? And how the hell can I be expected to play this anymore after that? Now you might be thinking, well, you've compared this game a fair lot to Mario 64, why don't you just skip past the last star and come back to it later like in that game? Well, that's the thing. You can't do that in Mario Sunshine. If you get stuck on one shine you can't complete the rest of the level either. Now there are some secret shines you can grab to make up for this. For example, getting 100 coins in the first level gets you a shine, a little homage to Mario 64's 100 coin star, or in Noki Bay, there's a golden bird you can spray up on higher area to get one. But that's the thing, those are secret shines that are not required. You can get those from any time if you want to. Let me give you an example of why this sucks. Let's say you're playing Mario 64 for the first time and you can't figure out how to kill King Babomb. That's entirely okay because there are other shines you can get to make up for it. The 8 red coins, the Chain Chomp's Gate, the 100 coins, you get what I mean. But let's say you're in Rico Harbor and can't figure out how to beat the squid boss for the first shine. You can't get any other story shine in Rico Harbor. It feels so gridlocked to one path. Like, if you can't beat the squid jet skiing, tough shit, you don't get to do anything else. It feels like exploring is against the rules and you have to play it one way. Because shit, man, if I could have skipped Shine 3 and Serena Beach, I would have. And I would have skipped Shine 4 too, because it might be worse. So you have to go down to the casino underneath the hotel for this one, where you'll have to get triple sevens on both of these slot machines that make a big shine pattern on the main one. The left one you need to get sevens on individually, and the right one you're just straight gambling. I was about to go off on a tangent about why this is flawed, but genuinely, does this look fun? I'm going to let the raw gameplay footage play for 5 seconds, and I want you to tell me, does this look fun?
If you said yes, you're lying.
Hey, here's some key art I commissioned for this video out of rage that I didn't end up needing for the thumbnail. I don't know why this had to do anything with anything, I just thought it looked cool. It was Dude Swabmaster again, in case you're wondering. You just gamble! And that's it! That's the gameplay! That's how you get this shine! What even were they thinking? Okay, so you finally get all the sevens and have to create the big shine pattern with Flood. The issue is, it's a water gun. It gets everywhere. If you were one tile away and try to spray it, there's a good chance every tile surrounding it is going to get wrapped up in it as well. Okay, so you've finally gone through all of the painstaking gambling, and what's on the other side waiting for you is,
I'm gonna do it.
And to continue on with gambling, we have the immediate next shrine where you fight that is not King Boo. So handicapped Boo here is a different boss from anything else we've had yet. Like the shine previously, it's all about slots. You need to wait until he rolls triple pineapples in order to attack him. He'll throw fruit everywhere, which you can grab a pepper and chuck it at his tongue. Then throw a completely unrelated fruit at him next to deal damage. The problem is you have to wait until he rolls 3 pineapples. It's literal RNG, get good. Not even chasing Shadow Mario here is fun at all. It's so easy to lose track of him because of all the walls. Then there's the 8 red coins, which can kiss my ass. It's impossible to get all of these things without a guide, I swear. And special shoutouts to this one shine where you literally just clean up paint for 3 minutes. F***ing fantastic. Serena Beach is definitely the worst level in the game. Every shine was either way too cryptic, boring, or just blatantly random. This level just encapsulates everything I hate about this game. Its cryptic nature, its strange-ass design choices, and its damn repetitiveness. I sincerely hope the next level is something good, because I've just about had it! We're finally off to the second to last stage, Pianta Village. Honestly, pretty mixed about this one. I thought the first shine was pretty funny, though, because you have to throw these 2 chain chomps into water in which they instantly dissolve, then Flood tells us to not abuse animals, as if we didn't just f***ing evaporate 2 dogs. It's also home to one of the most creative shines, I think. Shadow Mario takes Flood from Mario at the very start of the level, and you have to get him back, which is tricky because everywhere is now surrounded by this fire goop. Now, the intended thing to do is navigate around the bottom side of the village, trying to get back to the top. The problem is the town is surrounded by giant-ass palm trees that just easily let you jump towards the center, completely circumventing the intended path and clearing the shine in like 2 minutes. On that note, though, I really do like the vibe of this area. This little community elevated above the rest of Isle Delfino, built on top of a giant mushroom, is such a creative idea for an area. I think that's honestly the best part of Mario Sunshine. How creative it is. Next to Wonder and Odyssey, it's probably the most experimentive Mario game. A cliffside town you need to use a boat to maneuver through, a haunted casino, a big-ass harbor, which is an aesthetic Nintendo has never used past this point. It just feels so different from every other Mario game. What definitely aids this is the enemies. I think this is definitely the most creative Mario cast in the whole series. The Piantas and Nokis are all almost entirely distinct from one another. A giant eel, gambling addict King Boo, these little dudes named Strolling Stews that are just this game's Goomba equivalent, Cataquacks that throw you into the air, a Monty Mole and a cannon, giant goop piranha plants. The only times I think they ever have Mario enemies returning is when they remix them, like Boos that masquerade as coins or the rockets that Bowser mech fires. It's super creative when it comes out and mixes things up. But then in the same thought, it also hits you with repetitive bullshit like Shine 4 and Pianta Village is literally just the chain chomp thing again, but way more obnoxious. Still though, it's a really unique and creative enemy. And on the topic of creative enemies and characters. Alright, so you're probably expecting me to go off into some kind of tangent about why I hate Shine 5 and the special stage attached to it, but damn it, man, the Chucksters are just so funny, I can't hate this one. These are Chucksters, Piantas that specialize in throwing Mario 1 billion feet in the air, which makes it far too easy for you to get thrown off a cliff. I should be upset about this, but the concept is so out there and nonsensical, I can't hate it. It also gives you a free 1-up at the start, so there's like no chance of having to restart the entire process of getting here. By technicality, my favorite special stage, even though I like it because it's dumb as hell. Pianta Village overall is just fine to me. No other shines really stand out besides those. On the same topic of repetitiveness from a second ago, though, you have to chase down Shadow Mario like 10 whole times in this game. It's insane. It was fun the first couple of times, and now it's just annoying. Well, I'm in luck, because after chasing down Shadow Mario in every level, the entirety of Delfino Plaza becomes flooded, and Shadow Mario is waiting for you by the entrance to the final area of the game, Corona Mountain.
Hey, remember that lily pad level?
Yeah, that's what Corona Mon is.
The first half is you having to jump across these platforms that can either have spikes on them or fire. You can extinguish fire by spraying it, but it doesn't stay like that for too long. Then there's the other platforms which have spikes that deploy and retract after a few seconds. After you're through with that though, you have to guide this boat along the lava, and if it touches anything, it sinks. I'm going to be 100% honest with you, this level's difficulty is way overblown. It's actually pretty easy to guide the boat along, you people are just being way too dramatic. I only died twice here actually, which is way less than I thought it would be. Once you reach the end, you can grab the rocket nozzle and platform off these clouds to reach the top, revealing Peach and Bowser Jr., but not just them, Bowser's along with them, making this his first and last appearance in the game. I mean, hey, it's fine, this isn't the first time he's warped through space and time to be the final boss or something. Anyway, this final boss blows hard. He literally just sits in a bathtub the whole time exhaling fire at you. Bowser Jr. sits in a little boat shooting bullet bills at you, but because you have the rocket nozzle and how you have to hit them, they barely matter. All you have to do is go around this bathtub 5 times and hit the ground pound spaces. This boss fight seriously feels like they just ran out of ideas and threw something at the wall. It's pathetically easy. Yay, Bowser's defeated. We restore light to the whole island. The game really forces a death scene with Flood, which is impossible to take seriously because I am not attached to this thing in the slightest. Bowser and Bowser Jr. perpetuate the cycle of generational trauma, and we roll credits. So that's Mario Sunshine. But not really. You see, I've gone over pretty much everything I wanted to talk about with this game, except for one thing. 100% completion. There is one collectible I have purposely left out of discussion up until this point, and that is the blue coins. Blue coins can be found randomly in different acts of the game, and netting 10 of them will let you be able to exchange them for a shine. The problem is netting 10 of them. If there were a set amount in every level as a whole, that would be one thing. But there are some blue coins that are hidden within specific acts of levels. So let's say you're going for every shine in the game. You would have to get all 240 blue coins, and let's say you have 239. There is no way of telling which level and which act that one blue coin could be in, so you have to scour each and every act and each and every level to find it. Not just levels either, there is some hidden in Delfino Plaza as well. And I've been meaning to say this whole time, but there's no way I could possibly smoothly transition into it, but what kind of name is Delfino Plaza? Now entering Hawaii Square! I love going for 100% completion in games. The process of grabbing every little thing and getting some kind of cool reward for your hard work is really satisfying for me. Grabbing every regular shine seems possible, hell, it's downright doable, but I just don't want to because then I'll have to get every blue coin alongside it. So, no, I'm not grabbing every shine. I'm not going to follow up on that extra shine at Delfino Plaza I brought up earlier because this game can go fuck itself. This game is just so frustrating with all of its stupid little design decisions. Why does he control like this? Who made the game this cryptic? Why are so many shines stupidly repetitive? What the hell am I doing here anymore? Mario Sunshine is a complete mixed bag of a game. There will be some times where I see glimmers of hope shining through the cracks of this game, and I can really see what they were trying to do with this. Like, don't get me wrong, the vibes this game has is immaculate. The music feels so comforting, the enemies and characters feel so unique, the aesthetics are impeccable, and this is like peak world building. No other Mario game feels this connected. But every time I start to enjoy myself with Mario Sunshine, I enter another damn special stage, and I start thinking, wow, I really wish I could be doing anything else right now. Honestly, I wish I could enjoy Mario Sunshine like other people do, but there's so many little things that just drag it down significantly for me. Mario's slipperiness, the blue coins, the entirety of that damn hotel. But at the end of the day, I actually really don't like this game. I don't have anything like insightful to say. I'm not going anywhere at this. Honestly, this video is just kind of like vent art for me. I really don't have anything that positive to say about it. I mean, I liked some aspects like the music and other things, but really, I just don't. It's just not a very fun Mario game for me. I mean, it's cool if you enjoy it, but like, it's just not the kind of thing I would enjoy. You know? Okay, bye.